Hello guys, this is Abhijit and today we'll study about line integral. Okay, so before starting line integral, let me remind you a bit about the integral that you have already studied. Okay, so the integral that you have already studied looks like given any function y of x. Okay, what do? You do integration y of x dx, and earlier I stated that this kind of object, they give you area under the curve y of x. Okay, so we have done this in a particular video where I have explained you the definite integral and the double integral. And let me tell you something most important, that this integral and this integral are different things. I mean the normal definite integral that you have studied in your plus 2 and the line integral that you will study in your BSc course, they are both different. Okay, the only difference is the presence of a dot product. So the only difference between this and this is a dot product. Okay, the only difference is a dot product. So first, let us try to understand what you mean by dot product, and then we will move on to understand the line integral. Okay, so consider I give you a force. So the force is given by 2i plus 2j. Okay, so if I give you a force like this, so and I say there is a displacement s which is given by 2i cap. Agreed? So now, if I ask you to find the work done, you know how to find the work done. You'll easily say that, okay, work done is F dot S, okay, that you have done mathematically, okay, and it is very easy. You'll get 2i plus 2j dot 2i, and you'll get a 2i dot 2i, because the 2j dot 2j will give you answer 0. That will be 2 dot 2, because I dot I is 1, and we get answer 4. Okay, so this is mathematics. This is just mathematics. Now, what is the physical reason behind this mathematics? I mean, what is the physics behind this mathematics that we have done just now? So let us try to understand the physics behind the mathematics. So the force is given as 2i plus 2j. What do you mean by force 2i plus 2j? So let us try to draw a vector that looks like 2i and 2j. So if I draw a coordinate system, okay, say this is x and this is y. I hope you know how to draw 2i and 2j. 2i means in the x we have to take 2, 2j means in the y we have to take 2. And then we'll draw a vector. Okay, I mean this will be the point 2, 2. Okay, and then you draw a vector from 0 to this point. So this is a vector, and this vector is actually what? 2i plus 2j. So this line that you see is 2i plus 2j. So this is actually the force. This vector is actually the force. Now, what is the, whenever we talk about force, we actually talk about the magnitude of force, like 10 Newton force is acted upon a body, or 20 Newton force is acted upon a body. So what does this mathematics is trying to say something about the magnitude of force? So what is the magnitude of force? You know that the magnitude of force will be root over of 2 square plus 2 square. That will give you a root over of 8, that is 2 root 2 Newton. Agreed? So given a vector which is 2i plus 2j is equivalent to saying that I have given you a force 2 root 2 Newton. Okay, but there is one more thing. The direction of force you see is not along x-axis, neither the direction of force is along y-axis. Direction of force is along some arbitrary angle. Say this angle is theta. Okay, so can you guess what theta is? Without mathematics, can you guess it? It's very easy. You see the point, you see this line, it passes through 2, 2. So it will also pass through 1, 1. And it will also pass through 3, 3. So a line which passes through 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is called y equals to x. And that type of line intuitively has an angle theta equals to 45 degree. Okay. If you want me to calculate, I'll also calculate. Let us calculate. So how do I know? So let me draw this vector here. So what is this vector? This is 2 root 2. Agreed? Now, what is this line and what is this line? This line is 2 and this line is also 2. So, what is cos theta? Cos theta is base by hypotenuse. Okay, so base is 2 and hypotenuse is 2 root 2. So, what is the answer? The answer is 1 by root 2. So cos theta is 1 by root 2 is valid for theta equals to 45 degree. Agreed? So what is my cos theta? Cos theta is equals to 45. Oh, sorry. Cos theta, value of cos theta is 1 by root 2. And the value of theta is 45 degree. Okay. So this type of mathematics that says force is 2y plus 2j, this type of mathematics is saying that you are given a force whose magnitude is 2 root 2 Newton, and that force is acting on an object at an angle 45 degree. Say the object is kept here. Say I have kept a block of mass m here. Then you see that the force is acting at an angle 45 degree to the block of mass m. So what you understand from, you understand that the idea of angle in which the force is acting is hidden in this mathematics. Agreed? This cos theta value, or I can say that the angle in which the force is acting, is hidden already in this mathematics. Now, then I need to understand what is s equals to 2y. Now, s is the displacement of the object. I mean, s is the distance till which the force is acted upon. Okay. So, 2i, I means x direction, so the distance is approximately 2 meter. So what is the distance? So distance is 2 meter. So what is the physics behind this and this mathematics? The physics behind this and this mathematics is, you are given a force whose magnitude is 2 root 2 Newton and acting at a direction, or acting at an angle 45 degree to the object. Okay, and the displacement is 2 meter. So what is work done? You know work done. W is equals to F dot S. Please understand, dot is very important. Okay. Why the dot is important? Okay, so let us forget this. Okay, for a moment, let us forget this. Okay. Now, so whenever you are given to find work done, you need to find the force acting on the object and the displacement. Since the displacement is acting along the x-axis, because it is given 2i, I means x-axis. So the displacement is actually acting along x-axis. So if the displacement is acting along x-axis, you need to find the force that is acting along x-axis. Now, this force is acting at an angle theta. So can you tell me, which force is acting along x-axis? The component of this force along x-axis is the force acting along x-axis. So what is the component of this force along x-axis? It is F cos theta. And this F cos theta has pushed the block by a distance 2 meter. So I write the distance is S. Agreed? Now, so what is F cos theta S? It is nothing but F dot S. Okay, so F dot S, the use of dot product is actually conveying you the message that the force must act in the direction of displacement. Agreed? So can we calculate this work done? Yes, we can calculate this. What is our force? Let us use this. Force is actually 2 root 2 Newton. What is our cos theta? Is 1 by root 2. And what is our displacement? It is 2. So what do we get? We get 2 dot 2 that is equals to 4. Agreed? So now compare this part. So here work done was 2 dot 2 and here also we got work done as 2 dot 2 that is 4. So you see here we have used f dot s cos theta, we have used fs cos theta, and here we have used the usual vector notation. So we have used two different methodology for the same physical problem. So in this particular explanation, what I want to say is the information of cos theta or the information of direction in which the force is acting is already encoded in the mathematics in which it is written. You see the way F and S is written? The way F and S is written, they already carry the information of the angle theta. Agreed? So, dot is very important. Okay. So, dot product means you have to use a cos theta. Now the either you use this, either you if you are given force, if you are given a displacement and you are given an angle, then you can use this particular formula to find the work done. But if you are given a vectorial form of force and displacement, then you need to use this mathematics. And if you compare this and this, they are the two different way of solving the same physical problem. That's two different ways of solving the same physical problem. So in this way, this 2i, 2j, 2i, this type of mathematics, they already encode the information of cos theta. Agreed? So conclusion is, our work done is always written as f with a dot and an s. See, answer of a dot product is a scalar. So what do we get? We get just a number here. Okay. So if the units are okay, if the unit of force is in Newton and distance is in meter, then I can write 4 joule and I can write a 4 joule here. Agreed? Now, let us take one step forward. Okay? So what are the things that we are going to do in one step forward? What if you have a particular distribution of force? Okay, so let us try to understand. So, you know, gravitational field, electric field, you might have studied this. So, the gravitational field, electric field are actually distribution of force in space. I can use the term distribution of force in space because you see anywhere on the surface of the earth or over the surface of the earth, everywhere the gravitational force is acting. Okay, everywhere. You take it on the ground or above the ground, 1 meter above the ground, 2 meter above the ground, it is always acting. If you keep a charge, if you keep an electric charge in space, you find that the electric charge in space creates an electric field, and that electric field is nothing but electric force, and that force is acting everywhere in space, and that force will be acting everywhere in the space. So this is what I mean by distribution of force. This is what I mean by distribution of force. So let me give you an example. The example is, consider I take a object from point A to point B. Okay. Now, say I take an object along this curve. I take an object along this curve. Now, and I tell you that this object is pushed from A to B by a force F. Okay, this object is pushed from A to B by using a force F, but the direction of force F was always acting in a direction tangent to the curve. I mean that when the object is here, the force is acting along the tangent F. when the object is here, the force was acting, say, like this along the tangent. So when the object was here, the force was acting along the tangent. So if the object is taken from A to B, and at each and every point the force was acting tangent, for example here the force was acting tangent, it means it was acting in the direction of the curve, or it was acting in the direction of displacement. In this case, if the condition of the force is that the force was always acting tangent, then I can say that work is equals to F into displacement AB. I can easily write this. Okay, but if I give you a force distribution which is not like this, this was a very beautiful force distribution. The beauty of this force distribution is that at each point the force is F, and that force was acting along the displacement. At each and every point the force was acting along the displacement. This example is same as if I take a block and I push it by using a force F in the x direction. You see, at each and every point where the block is going, the force was always acting in the direction of displacement. So if the force is always acting in the direction of displacement, then we can say that the work done is given by the force dot displacement AB. Now, since the force is always acting in the direction of displacement, the dot will be cos theta, and theta will be 0 degree. So what you will get? You just get a multiplication F and S. You just get a simple multiplication. So now if I give you another example, so I give you a distribution of force like this. At each and every point, the force is acting upward. So this is my distribution of force. Say this type of force is created by anything. I mean, there is a collection of positive charges here, and this collection of positive charges is giving a force upward, in upward direction. Okay. Now, in this particular example, what I'm going to do is I need to find the work done in taking an object from this point A to this point B along a curve which is given as this. Agreed? Along a curve which is given in this way. So let me draw some more force. Now, how many lines are there? I can say there are infinite number of lines, because this is an entire force generated. Okay, these are not individual forces, entire force field acting upward. Agreed? Now, if I ask you what is the work done by this force field in taking an object from A to B, agreed? What is the work done? Now, in order to calculate work done, what you need to do, you need to multiply force into displacement. Now, in this case, we have a problem. The problem is the force is acting in the upward direction and the displacement is in this direction. If I take an object from C to D, always perpendicular to the force, if I take an object from C to D such that the object is always perpendicular to the force, then no work is done by the field, because at each and every point, if we calculate the work done, if we use F dot S, the cos theta will have a 90 degree, because the displacement is occurring along this direction and the forces are acting along the upward direction. So the angle is always a 90 degree. In this case, the work done by the field in taking an object from C to D is zero, straight zero. But the work done in taking an object from A to B is not zero. Is not zero. There is a reason. The reason is, if you look at it closely, See, at this point, okay, I say there is no work done because the displacement is in this direction and the angle here is 90 degree. So at this point, there is no work done. Can I say there is a particular work done here? You would say why? Because you see, this force can be divided into two components, one in this direction and another in the direction of displacement. Okay, so for small amount of distance here, this force has a component in the direction of displacement. So there is a small amount of work W del W1 done here. If we go a little forward, if you look at this graph will also have a normal and a tangential component. The normal component does no work, but this tangential component for this small amount of distance has done some work DW2. Now, there are, as I said, infinite number of lines. As we go forward, let us focus at this diagram. At this point, from here to here, this force has two components. One is in this direction and one is along the direction of the displacement. So a small amount of work at this point is done, DW say 6. Now why these are all different? Because the angle is different. The component of force acting here and the component of force acting here is different for the same small distance delta x or dr. Since this is done in 2D, okay, say this is the y direction and say this is the x direction, then any displacement I can say as dr. Okay, so what is the total work done? You know, in this case, when you have to find the total work done, you actually have to add all these work done by the components at different places. You see, at different places, the components that are acting are different because the angle was going on changing. So when I'm asked to find the total work done, I actually need to add all the work done. W1, then I need to add W2 and ... So many work done till I go from A to B. This can be written in a very structured manner. Summation I del W I, because this long term can be written in short as this. Okay, now this can also be written as summation I F I dot del R I. Why did I write this? Why did I write F I? Because at each point the force, the component of force is going to be different because I'm going to use a cos theta here and the cos theta is changing with I. What do you mean by cos theta? By cos theta I mean the angle between the force and the displacement. I mean this angle, the angle here, the angle here and the angle here. Agreed? Now, so since at different places the F cos theta is different because the theta is different, hence my work done is different, as a result of which I need to add all the work done, or I can write it as this. And we have already known that the big brother of this type of term we have done in our previous lecture in integral and double integral, the big brother of this term is actually what? Integration F dot dr. Agreed? Integration F dot dr from where to where? From A to B. From A to B. So what do you understand from here? You understand the most important point here is a line integral is nowhere related to area under a curve. That is point number one. Point number two, line integral, a type of line integral that I have given you here, is actually summing up f dot dr at different places from A to B. It is summing up f dot dr from all places a to b. Now, why it is summing up? The reason I need to sum it up because my force at the component of force acting along the displacement was different. That's why I had to sum up. Here I didn't have to sum up. Here I didn't have to sum up because here the entire displacement a to b, this is the total displacement as ab. The entire displacement as ab, the force was acting along the direction of displacement. Hence, I just multiplied the force and the total displacement, that is SAB. But in this case, I need to integrate it because the force was itself a function of R. So this can be written in a more precise manner. This can be written as integration A to B F, which is a function of R dot dr. Okay, so what do you understand by line integral? Line integral like this is summing up the small contributions of work done. Now, why small contributions of work done? Because the component of force was continuously changing. Okay, so this was how line integration was invented. So line integration was there to help us calculate the dot product along a particular curve. I repeat again, line integral was there to help us calculate the dot products along a particular curve. If the dot product is different at different points, then we need the help of this force to calculate the contribution of all the dot product to get the total dot product from A to B. Here our dot product was actually work done. Okay, now let us solve some examples. Until unless you find some you do some examples, you won't understand this. You please note it down. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll give you an example where I'll give you a force in terms of I and j. Okay, and after giving you the force, what I'll do is I'll make a diagrammatic representation of the distribution of that force that I'm going to use as an example, and then I will give a particular graph. I mean, I gave you a particular curve along which the force is gonna act. Okay, and then we are going to find the work done. Okay, so what are we going to do here? Consider I give you a force, a distribution of force that looks like this: x plus y I plus y minus x j. Okay, now how does the distribution of force looks like? Let us plot it. Okay, I'm gonna rub it, but let me plot it. At x equals to 1 and y equals to 1, my force is 2i and this is 0. So let us draw, say this is x and this is y. At 0, 0, it is 0 and this is also 0. So there is no force at the origin. At 1, 1, see, you see the force is acting along which direction? In the I cap direction. At 1, 1, there is this force that is acting along I direction, I mean the x direction. What is the magnitude of the force? It is 2 Newton. Now, let us see what happens at x equals to 1 and y equals to 2. So, if this is x equals to 1 and this is y equals to 1. So, at x equals to 1 and y equals to 2. So at this point, what is the force? At this point, the force is F is equals to 3i plus 1j. Quite interesting. So what is the magnitude of force? The magnitude of force would be root 3 square plus 1. I think it is 10. Root 10 Newton. And in which direction the force is acting? The force is acting along a particular direction given by 3i and 1j. Can you find the direction? It's very easy. Remember how we calculate the direction? Let me give you the direction of this force. Let me do it here. So so the force has the y component 1, the x component 3, and the hypotenuse as root 10. So what is cos theta? Cos theta is base by hypotenuse. So what is my base? 3 by root 10. Okay, so you need to calculate. Okay, 3 by root 10. I don't know what is the angle, but somehow I can tell you that here the force is somewhere in this direction. So the magnitude of force is root 10 Newton and it is acting along in this direction. Here the magnitude of force was only 2 Newton acting along the x direction. Similarly, you can just plot this force in the entire 2D surface. You can take any point and each and every point the force will be in this direction, somewhere the force will be in this direction, somewhere the force is going to go in this direction, somewhere the force is going to go in this direction. So it is just a random nature. I mean, you have to calculate it. So if you plot it in a particular software, you can see the entire distribution of force in this space. So this force distribution is given by this mathematics. Agreed? So I hope you understood the force distribution. Now, so you are given a force distribution along a 2D blackboard or whiteboard. You see, consider this is the force distribution. Now if I ask you, if I take a particular object in this force distribution, if I take a particular object along a curve given by y square equals to x, what I'll do is, say I have two points. I have point A and I have a point B, and I take an object along some direction from A to B in this force distribution. Okay, let me make it darker. Okay, so this is the direction from A to B. I take my object. Now if I ask you that this is the given force and this is the given curve along which the object is taken, and the object is taken from 1 1 to say 4 2, and I ask you, what is the total work done when the object is taken from A to B? Well, it's difficult to calculate. Why? Because you see, the distribution of force is very strange. Here there will be a different component along which the force will have a direction. If this force will have a different component along this direction, this force will have a different component along this direction, and say here is a force that will have a different component along the direction of displacement. So at each point I need to find out the force and I need to multiply the force component along the displacement with the displacement, and I have to do it for the entire path A to B. That's very tedious work. You have to find the distribution and then you will do that. It's very tedious work. And the beautiful formula that we have with us is, we have the line integral. So just use the line integral. So what is the line integral says? So all, if you want to find the total work done from A to B, all you need to do is, you need to integrate f dot dr. That's it. Okay, instead of doing this complicated process, use this formula. Now how to use it? Now, can you please tell me what is dr? We know that every r can be written as xi plus yj. So what will be dr? So dr will be dxi and dy j. Agreed? So what is my f? X plus y. So what I'll do is, let me write it in full form. X plus y I plus y minus x j. So this force is in dot with dx I and dy j. So what are you going to get? You will get integration from where to where? 1, 1, that is my A, to 4, 2, that is my B. And what I get here? I get x plus y dx and I get y minus x dy. Are we done? No, we are not done here yet. Why we are not done here yet? Because I have not included here the information of the curve. Is there anywhere I have included that my curve looks like this? No. So I have not included it. So how to include the information of the curve? It's very simple. Here in the x, just put y square. In place of x, just put y square. So what will happen with dx? So if my x is given as y square, then my dx will be 2y dy. Agreed? So what this integration is gonna look, this entire integration, it's gonna be in the form of y. So where do our y go from? Our y go from 1 to 2. So our y goes from 1 to 2. In place of x, just put y square. Because by putting x as y square, I am including the information of the curve along which I am doing my work. So what is dx? It is 2y dy plus y minus y square. So if I take both the di outside, I get this particular dy. Now look, this is just a plus 2 integration. Okay, it's a very simple integration, and after solving this, you will get the answer as 11 1 by 3 joule. So if the force says in Newton and the displacement from A to B is in meter, then you will get a work done which is equivalent to 11 1 by 3. So what is 11 1 by 3? That is actually, so 33 plus 1, 34 by 3 joule. This is the work done. Now, so what we have done in the line integral, we are given a force, we are given a curve, and we are given from where to where the object was taken. So we are given with three things, 1, 2, 3. In the line integral, we included the information of the force and we got this, and then we found this, and then here we need to put the information of the curve along which we are doing the, along which we are finding the work done. So this is our curve. So how to include the information of curve? Just in place of x, put y square. So indirectly I have used the information of my curve, and then this gets converted into a very simple integration. The entire integration is in y, and then you use the formulas, very simple formulas, and you will get your answer 34 by 3. Got it? So this is how line integration is done. Now this can also be solved in a different manner. So by different manner, I will teach you now about parameterization. Okay, so we have to learn about parameterization, because that is very easy. By using parameterization, the line integration equations are very easy to solve, and sometimes just putting the value of equation in the line integral is not enough. Okay, so what was our question? Our question was, so this is our graph, y square equals to x, and this is our force. So what do you mean by parameterization? Okay, so consider you have an object that follows this path. So this is A and this is B. Okay, now, so this is x-axis and this is y-axis. If I ask you how to draw the path A to B, then you will tell me that in order to draw the path from A to B, either give me equation, either give me the equation, or you give me for all x what are the values of y, so that I can plot the entire AB. Agreed? So if these two informations are given, or any one of these information is given, you can plot AB. Now I can tell you there is another way you can plot the AB. How? If I give you the information of radius vector for all the points A to B. If I tell you that here the radius vector is this, and here the radius vector is this, here the radius vector is somewhat this, so here the radius vector is less, as you go towards B, the length of radius vector is increasing. So if I give you a formula, say R is a function of T. So what is T? is just a number. T, say r equals to t is some t square plus t. Okay, so what you will do? Put the value of t as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, for every value of t, you will get a value of r, and for each r, you draw a line. And then you go on drawing the line of all the r that you can get from here. And then you join the tip of the r. You join the tips of all the r. Then you will get the curve AB. Agreed? So this is the third way to get the curve AB. That is, if I give you the information of radius vector and how the radius vector depends on a particular parameter. Agreed? So this is called parameterization of a curve. Now, so the idea here is, what is parameterization? The idea is you use only one parameter, and this one parameter gives you the entire curve from A to B. So this one parameter gives you the entire curve from A to B. What is the parameter here? The parameter here is t. Okay, and this particular equation that is required, how the radius vector is changing with t. So using this idea, we are going to solve this equation, I mean this line integral. So what to do here? So you just use, say x equals to, so use y equals to t. So if y is t, what is my x? X is t square, because x is equals to y square. Agreed? Now, what is my force? What is my force gonna look? My force is gonna look as this is t square plus t I plus t minus t square j. So this is my force. Agreed? So what is my dr gonna look like? So if I have my dr, I know that dr is dx I plus dy j. So what is dx? So dx is gonna be 2t dt along I cap. And what is my dy? It will be dt along j cap. What to do next? All you need to do is you need to multiply f dot dr, and then you need to integrate it. So if I do f dot dr, so what will I get? I'll get t square plus t multiplied with 2t plus t minus t square, with both having the dt outside. Agreed? Then I need to integrate. I integrate it here, I integrate it here. Now the question is, from where to where? So t is going from where to where? So we need to find what t is. I mean, we need to find the interval of t. Now, what is the information given? The information is given, the first curve was initially we started at x equals to 1, y equals to 1, and then we got ended with x equals to 2, y equals to 4. And we have two more information. The information is x is equals to t square and y is equals to t. Now, can you guess the value of t which is going to satisfy this? Can you guess the value of t which is going to satisfy this? Yes. If my t goes from 1 to 2. Let us see how. So if the t is 1, then I can put t equals to 1 here, I get y1 and x1. That's my initial point. If I put y as 2, I get my x as 4. Made a mistake. The x was actually 2, I mean 4. Okay, if you look at the equations here, the x was 4 and it's 2. So t goes from 1 to 2, because when the t is 2, I get x equals to 4 and y is equals to 2. So my t goes from 1 to 2. Now, if you compare this equation with the previous equation, you will see that in place of t, we had y. In place of t, we had y. And then you calculate it, you'll get the answer 11, 1 by 3. Agreed. Now you suddenly ask a question. What is the use of this parameterization stuff? If we can just plot x as y square, we just got the same equation just in terms of y. So what is the use of this parameterization? Well, in this example, it is very easy. But in the next example, you are going to see the power of parameterization. Okay, I hope this example is clear. In the next example, what I'll do is I'll give a particular force equation and I'll ask you to find the work done along a circle. Along a circle, but we'll only concentrate on the first quadrant of that circle. Okay. And then in the second example, you will actually see the power of the parameterization. Okay. So consider you are given a force minus y I and minus x y j. So this is some arbitrary distribution of force that you are given with. And then you are asked that what is the work done in taking the object along a circle from A to B, and the radius of the circle is 1. I mean, you are taking this object along a circular path, okay, from where? From this point. So this point will be actually 0, and this point will be 1 0. And this point, since the radius is 1, so this point will be 0 and 1. And you are taking it along a circle. So you are given with the force equation, you are given with the limits, and you are given with the curve equation. The curve is a circle. So what's the plan? The plan is we have to do work done. We have to find work done, that is F dot dr. But we need to somehow put the information of the circle here along with the information of force here. So question is how to put the information. Okay, here comes the power of parameterization. In a circle, the circle follows this particular equation, x square plus y square is equals to radius square, which in our case is 1 square. That is 1, because as I've said, the radius is taken as 1. Agreed? Now, we know that if we use x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sine theta. Since our r is 1, we can take x is equals to cos theta and y is equals to sine theta. Now, you would ask, why are we doing this stuff? Because instead of x and y, we only get theta. We don't need to play with two variables that we did in our previous example. All we need to do is play with theta. It becomes so simple. Look at this. So what is my dr? My dr is actually dx along I plus dy along j. So this is gonna be looking like d of x will give me minus sine theta along I direction, and d of y will be, I'm writing it here, so d of x is minus sine theta d theta, and d of y is cos theta d theta. So it's gonna be cos theta j with a d theta remaining there. Agreed? So that will be a small d theta. Okay, now what is my force gonna look? It's very easy. You just plot these values. So my force is gonna look like as minus sine theta I and minus sine theta cos theta j. That's it. You got your force in terms of parameter theta. And you got your dr in terms of parameter theta. Now you can easily do the dot product of f dot dr. Okay. And the theta, from where to where? You look, the theta is going from 0 degree to 90 degree. So when you integrate it, everything will come in terms of theta. F is in terms of theta, dr is in terms of theta, and the limit is from 0 to pi by 2. And when you solve this integral, you get your work done as pi by 4 minus 1 by 3. So I have skipped the step. So I hope you do this integral by yourself. It's a very easy. All you need to do is f dot dr. Okay. So once you do f dot dr, all the i's and j's, they will vanish. You will get a term entirely in terms of theta. And then you need to integrate it because already there is a d theta. So you need to integrate it from 0 to pi by 2. I need you to solve this integral and then find for yourself that you get the answer as the work done given here. That is pi by 4 minus 1 by 3. Agreed? So I hope these two examples have given you an idea of how to actually do line integral, or I mean how to solve line integral. Agreed? So in the next lecture, we are going to talk about conservative and non-conservative forces, and we will use the idea of work done to find conservative and non-conservative forces. Agreed? So we do it next class. Till then, bye bye.